Hello kids, welcome back to online class of Upper Public School. My name is Renuka Devi. I am handling social studies for grade 4. So in last class we have completed which lesson number? We have completed lesson number 13. And what was the name of the lesson? The name of the lesson was Agriculture in India. What was the name of the lesson? Agriculture in India. So what do you mean by agriculture? Agriculture is a practice of farming and cultivation of land to grow crops is called as agriculture. Other than farming, agriculture also includes livestock rearing and fishing. There are two types of crops. Yes, in last class we have studied two types of crops. Can you all guess which are those two types of crops? Yes, the two types of crops are, one is food crop and the other one is cash crops. What do you mean by food crop? Yes, what do you mean by food crop? What do you mean by food crop? A crop grown to feed people is called as food crop. A crop grown to feed people is called as food crop. Which are the food crops? Can you all guess few of the food crops? Yes, rice, pulses, wheat. Yes, these are the, and many more are the food crops. And the other one is cash crop. The other one is cash crops. What do you mean by cash crops? Crops grown as raw materials for industries. Cash crops grown as raw materials for industries and sold for money is called as cash crop. Which are the cash crops? Cash crops are tea, coffee, sugar cane, yes, and many more are the cash crops. And also we have studied in last class livestock rearing and fishing. Yes, so one more thing I would like to inform you all, that lesson number 14 and 15, lesson number 14 and 15 will be explained later on. So today we are going to start lesson number 16. What is the name of the lesson? The name of the lesson today we are going to study is the Constitution of India. Constitution of India. So before starting this lesson, I would like to say one small story. What is that? Suma asked her mother, "Why do I have to follow traffic rules?" Her mother replied, "Suma, you have to follow traffic rules to be safe." Why should we follow the traffic rules? To be safe. If you do not follow them, you might hurt yourself. If you will not follow traffic rules, you will hurt yourself. We all follow traffic rules so that the traffic and the people move safely and easily. There are various rules and laws to be followed in our country. So why should we follow the traffic rules? to be safe and yes, and like that in our country we are having many more rules and laws. We will see in detail now. Why do we need laws? India is home to people of different languages, religions and cultures. In order to live together peacefully, a set of rules and regulations is required. After India gained independence on 15th August 1947, some rules and regulations were laid down for governing the country. So, today we are going to study lesson number 16, the Constitution of India. What do you mean by Constitution? The rule book where the rights and duties, the rule book where the rights and duties of a citizen are stated is called as Constitution of India. The rule book where the rights and duties of the citizen are stated is called as Constitution of India. 3 years after India's independence, 3 years after India's independence, the Constitution of India was implemented on 26 January 1950. The Constitution Assembly had 299 members. How many members? 299 members. In that, 9 of the members were women. Every year on this day, we celebrate as Republic Day. On 26 January, we celebrate it as Republic Day. It contains 470 articles. How many articles? 470 articles, which are grouped in 25 parts. How many parts? 25 parts. It is divided into three major parts. It is divided into three major parts, which are those preamble, 7 articles and amendment. The Constitution of India is the largest constitution in the world. The Constitution of India is the largest constitution in the world. It has 80,000 words. How many? 80,000 words. A drafting committee was set up to frame Constitution. The drafting committee was set up to frame the Constitution of India. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar was its chairperson. Who was the chairperson? Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. This Constitution took 2 years and 11 months. How many? 2 years. 2 years and 11 months to frame the Constitution. And Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is also called as father of Indian Constitution. The preamble, fundamental rights, fundamental duties and directive principles of state policy are important parts of Constitution. Preamble, fundamental rights, fundamental duties and directive principle of the state policies are the important part of Constitution. The original constitution of India was handwritten by Prem Bihari Naren Raizada. Each page was beautified and decorated by artists from Shanti Niketan. It was beautifully handwritten by Prem Bihari Naren Raizada. And it was beautifully decorated by the artist of Shanti Niketan. Here are few government of India. Executive, in that it consists of President, Vice President and Cabinet Minister. Responsibilities, what are the responsibilities? To pass the law made by the legislature. And legislature of parliament consists of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. What are the responsibilities? To make laws. Judiciary consists of Supreme Court of India. What are the responsibilities? To solve conflicts between executives and legislature, other public related matter or next comes levels of government. There are three levels of government. Which are those three levels? Central government, state government and local government. There are three levels of government. Which are those three levels of government? Central government, state government and local government. Next, moving on to preambles. Preamble acts as an introduction to the Indian Constitution and set out the guiding purpose and principles of nation. It is a set of goal. What it is? It is a set of goal that we need to achieve for making India a better nation. It states that India is a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic and republic. What does preamble include? It states that sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic and republic. Shall we learn in detail? First is sovereign. A sovereign country is independent of the authority of state. The government has full rights and power over itself. A government has full power and it can take any decision. Next is socialist. A socialist country is one where everyone is equal. Everyone is equal. There is no division among people based on caste, color or religion. What do you mean by socialist? Socialist is a country, is one where everyone is equal. A socialist country is one where everyone is equal. There is no division among people based on caste, color or religion. Next is secular. A secular country is one that follows people to practice any religion of their choice. What do you mean by secular? A secular country is one that follows people to practice any religion of their choice. Next is democratic. A democratic government is a government that is of the people, by the people, and for the people. A democratic country is a government that is of the people, by the people, and for the people. In a democracy, people have a right to elect the leader who will run the country. In democratic country, people have the rights to elect the person who runs the country. Next is republic. A republic is a country where the representatives are elected by the people to run the country. Here you can see the people voting. And here in this picture you can see a present ruling government. Next we will study about election. In a democracy, the citizens of a country have the right to vote and select their leaders. Means in a democratic country, people have the right to elect the person whom they want to rule the country. The party that gets the majority vote of the citizen forms the government. When we elect the person, which party gets the more vote, that party will rule the government, that party will rule the country. In this picture, you can see the voting machine here. You can see the voting machine. And in this picture, you can see how we will vote. This is voting machine. And here in this picture, you can see that the lady is voting. Here are the buttons that which party or which person you want to vote, you can press the button and you can elect. And on this, here you can see they are applying something. It is like a ink. They will apply on the finger so that you can identify easily that a person has put vote. India follows the rules of universal adult franchise. In this system of voting, the citizen of India have the right to vote without any discrimination based on one's caste, religion, color, and gender. The Constitution of India allows every citizen who has attended age of 18 cast his or her vote. At what age you can vote? After 18. After 18, you are eligible to vote a person whom you want to run the country. And India follows the universal adult franchise. In this system, of voting, the citizen of India have the right to vote without any discrimination. So in this session, what did we learn? We have learned about lesson number 16, and what is the name of the lesson? The Constitution of India. In that we have learned about the Constitution, right? And preambles. What are the preambles? Shall we repeat it once again? Sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, and republic. Shall we repeat? Sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, and republic. And even we have learned about elections. At what age we can start voting? You all, after 18, you all can start voting. So in this lesson, we have completed today first part. And one more thing I would like to say, repeat it once again, that lesson number 14 and 15 will be explained later on. Okay, so thank you. Have a nice day.